Thank you. Now faith is the assurance of things hoped for, the conviction of things not seen. Indeed, by faith, our ancestors received approval. By faith, we understand that the worlds were prepared by the word of God, so that what is seen was made from things that are not visible. By faith, Abel offered to God a more acceptable sacrifice than Cain's. Through this, he received approval as righteous, God himself giving approval to his gifts. He died, but through his faith, he still speaks. By faith, Enoch was taken so that he did not experience death, and he was not found, because God had taken him. For it was attested before he was taken away that he had pleased God. And without faith, it is impossible to please God. For whoever would approach him must believe that he exists, and that he rewards those who seek him. By faith, Noah, warned by God about events as yet unseen, respected the warning and built an ark to save his household. By this he condemned the world and became an heir to the righteousness that is in accordance with faith. Here ends the first reading.
Oh, Gospel of St. Mark. 6 days later, Jesus took with him Peter and James and John and led them up a high mountain apart by themselves. And he was transfigured before them, and his clothes became dazzling white, such as no one on earth could bleach them. And there appeared to them Elijah with Moses, who were talking with Jesus. Then Peter said to Jesus, "Rabbi, it is good for us to be here. Let us make three dwellings, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." He didn't know what to say, for they were terrified. Then a cloud overshadowed them, and from the cloud there came a voice. "This is my son, the beloved. Listen to him." Suddenly, when they looked around, they saw no one with them anymore, but only Jesus. As they were coming down the mountain, he ordered them to tell no one about what they had seen until after the Son of Man had risen from the dead. So they kept the matter to themselves, questioning what this rising from the dead could mean. Then they asked him, "Why do the scribes say that Elijah must come first?" He said to them, "Elijah is indeed coming first to restore all things. How then is it written about the Son of Man that he is to go through many sufferings and be treated with contempt? But I tell you that Elijah has come, and they did to him whatever they pleased, as it is written about him." Here ends the second lesson.
Thank you. let us pray. Almighty Father, God of grace and goodness, awaken us to your glory, that our lives may reflect your radiance, that we may share in your likeness, and in walking the way of Christ our Lord, may reveal your love to the world. Through the same Christ our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Lord, we pray that the glory of your presence may fill our lives and be reflected in all that we do. We ask that our churches may be radiant with your glory, that the gospel is not veiled from sight, but revealed in our actions and witness. We pray for all preachers, for ministers of the word and the sacraments, that they may reveal to us the face of our Lord Jesus Christ. And we especially remember any who are suffering for their faith. Lord, in your mercy, we give thanks for all you add beauty and glory to our world. We pray for artists, writers, musicians and craftspeople, for architects and planners, and for all who influence our daily lives. We pray for all who live in desolate areas and places of deprivation. Lord, in your mercy, we give thanks for all who have enriched our lives and improved our environment. We pray for those who work to meet our daily needs. We ask your blessing on our homes and places of work, upon our friends and our loved ones. Lord, in your mercy, we pray for any who are finding life dull or drab, for all who are getting no joy or satisfaction out of their life. We remember the stressed and the distressed, the overworked and the over-anxious. We ask for comfort and strength for all who are ill, and in a moment of quiet, we bring before God all those on our hearts and minds this evening. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray that we may be changed from glory to glory. We pray for all who now see you face to face, all who rejoice in the glory of your nearer presence. And we say together, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.
Thank you. 5432. Thank you very much. Yeah, I have a problem with my legs, so I've had to